Hare Krishna. To treat our emotions as the only reality is to live in unreality. When we go through life, we don't experience the events of life as much as we experience our emotions in relationship with the events. As for example, say if you are driving a car and suddenly the car lurches. Now the lurch of the car is a physical sensation, but we may start screaming, we may start panicking, and for us, although the lurching of the car has triggered the reaction, but we may get caught more in the emotion than in the situation. And to be caught too much in the emotion would mean that we may panic, we may freeze, we may overreact, and instead of getting the car back under control, we may let the car go further out of control. That means we are here, the emotion is here, and the situation is here. The situation may have triggered the emotion, but whether the emotion is helping us to deal with the situation or not, that is something which we have to see. If we start reacting more to the emotion than the situation, then our capacity to respond to the situation decreases. Now, an extreme is where somebody starts dealing only with the emotion and not the situation. So sometimes those people live completely inside their head, not connected with reality at all. So for example, some people get so emotionally disturbed, they think that someone has hurt them. And they start yelling at that person, complaining about that person, blaming that person. And now actually that person may have done nothing at all. But in their head, they have a script, a movie going on. Oh, this person did like this to me. That person may not have done it at all. And still, they may be blaming. So if we make our emotions our only reality, then we sentence ourselves to living in unreality. This is not to trivialize or reject our emotions, but we have to recognize that our emotions don't always arise from reality and they don't always reflect reality. So our emotions are a reality for us. But then the physical situation is also a reality. And if we want to deal with the situation, we have to focus on the situation. If the emotion arises from the situation, we address the emotion. If the emotion is simply coming from the imagination, then we have to learn to put aside the emotion. In the Bhagavad Gita in 18.25, Krishna says, Anubandham kshayam himsam anapekshacha paurusham mohadarabhyate karma yattatamasamuchyate. That mohad arabhyate karma, that work which is begun in illusion, that means there is no connection with reality. Just because of some conception in one's head, one starts off something. So it's a Krishna says, anubandham kshayam himsam. Such work is binding, it is violent, it is self-destructive. It does not consider the time, place, circumstance. It does not consider the effect on the others. It's simply a reaction to the illusion that is going on in the mind. And that condemns us to unreality. Sometimes this happens to alcoholics. They may be drunk and staggering along the road, about to topple with one push. But they may think they are the emperors of the world, commanding everyone. So they are responding only to the emotions in their head. Not to the reality at all. So, to the extent we become spiritually conscious, to the extent we understand that we are souls and we are parts of the whole of Krishna, to that extent we start recognizing that we are different from the situation and we are different from our emotions. And then we can objectively evaluate the emotion, and then respond appropriately to both in a mood of service to Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.